Bristol Community College Bayhawks versus Springfield Technical Community College.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to this edition of Bristol Community College Women's Basketball. I'm your host, Craig Salvador, flying solo today. We've got some quick action right out of the gate as the Bristol Bayhawks are taking on the Springfield Tech Rams. There's a long throw over to Misa Edwards. Misa Edwards going up for the layup, and she scores. Quick two right out the gate. Jamie Staples has the ball. Nice behind the back action, a little spin move. She's going to throw it over. That one is going to be bricked. Rebounded by Deborah Banks, passing over to Misa Edwards. Nice pass over to Luna. Thinking about a shot, gives it back to Edwards. They're going to call a travel on Katia Luna. So. Inbounded by Jill Jackis. Jock, I'm guessing. French. Staples over to Meadows, back to Staples, back to Meadows. Meadows pops the most line drive of threes, but that one goes in. Interesting shooting formation, but it works. So now the Rams with a quick lead, 3-2. Bounce pass over to Parrish, into Steele, Rosensteel, that is. And she puts that one in for an easy two. That is her shot. Staples with the handles. She's going to go at the top of the key. This one's not going to go in. They're going to call a foul. Leaf foul on Shannon Rosensteel. So Staples go to the line. Staples makes the second one. This is going to tie the game up now, 4-4. So now Megan Parrish coming down court with the ball. Parrish long throw over to Edwards. Edwards going to pop a three. That one's going to be overshot, and that's going to be caught by Asia Panton. Pant with a long toss over. I'm now joined by my partner, Dave Cardoza. Dave, thanks for coming.
Woo! It is so hard to be humble. What is going on? I'm David Cardoza, as I'm sure you've heard, the Portuguese cowboy over here. Glad to be here at Bishop Conley High School.
Meadows inbounds to Staples. Staples on no look over back to Meadows. That one gets stolen away by Rosensteel, throwing it back in to avoid the out of bounds. A nice pickup by Megan Parrish, passing it down to Misa Edwards. She's driving, she's going up, and she's not able to get it in.
Good drive, just couldn't get over the rim there. Got caught underneath.
It was the laziest dribble under the net ever. Staples goes up, throws it up, gets it herself, puts it back up, can't get it, gets it again. That was actually Katie Holmes who was the one to rebound that one.
So Ben, it's nice to be here on a Saturday. That sun shining through, nice bright gym. Feels like a little bit of liveliness to it.
Big 3-0. Rosensteel has it.
Not enough arc on that shot.
No. Before you came here, she threw one just like that, and she made it.
Yeah, well, just hit that line drive shot.
Exactly.
Need a little bit more arc.
So Springfield Tech are coming in this game 3-7, 2-4 in their league. And the Bayhawks, they're coming in at 6-10, 5-6 in their conference. Dave, we were at the last game where it was a close game to the end, but Bayhawks just weren't able to seal the deal.
Yeah, I felt like they dropped the ball in that game. Luckily, it's not a regional game, you know, but big regional game here today. BCC looking to go 6-6, be at 500 in the region. That's where it's all about.
Meadows driving with a bounce pass over to Asia Panton. Panton with nowhere to go. They're calling 3 seconds.
Good to be here on the C team today. Cardoza, Craig, and
Lucy.
And Cabral. Cardoza, Craig, and Cabral. Craig, a cowboy. The Portuguese cowboy.
So many C's. Parrish for three. That one just not able to tip in. There's a scramble for the ball. It goes out of bounds. It's going to stay in the Bayhawks' favor.
Megan Parrish had the open three there. Looked like she was going to drain it. That's her shot out there.
Yep. Luna with the pass to Edwards. Edwards going in, gives it to Banks.
Nice.
And Banks banks it for two.
Nice seal by Banks. Good job to get position and lays it up on the glass for the score. 6-4 now.
Staples to Meadows. Meadows to Panton. Panton looking for a shot. Stolen.
Ooh,
with ease by
Rosensteel.
With ease.
Took it from her like a baby.
Luna with her shot for three. This one gets rebounded by Panton. Staples looking for something.
Springfield spreading the floor. That's a deep three.
Got a pick, put up a three. Nothing to do with it, though. Edwards, the long throw to Parrish. That gets stolen away.
Good drive by Jamie Staples. Misses the three, but then comes back in. Comes back into the picture. Almost stole one there.
Ooh, Rosensteel not really expecting that one. She's going to put it up.
I feel like BCC doesn't come to the basketball enough. They're like.
I think Rosensteel's hurt. She looked like she was calling for the bench.
She'll be all right.
Yep.
Shake it off.
Long throw over to Staples in the corner. Staples steps back, puts it up off the rim, tip to Rosensteel. No good.
Staples getting some open looks there. Can't drain it, though.
Early on, she's definitely looking like the leader of this team. There's a great pass over to Deborah Banks, and she gets it. 2 points.
And that's been a connection here the last few times down court. Misha Edwards and Deborah Banks. Deborah Banks making herself available. Nice bounce pass by Misha Edwards. And BCC with an early lead. Just getting started here on a big basketball Saturday, Bayhawks basketball.
Something interesting, the Bayhawks are averaging 33 rebounds per game on the season. Something we've been seeing is they are getting a lot of rebounds, but they're not being able to put them back up for points.
Yeah, they're getting a lot of offensive rebounds. Yeah, you're right, Craig. It's BCC getting a lot of, you know, in a lot of games, they're getting a lot of offensive rebounds, but they're not able to put them back. Bayhawks shooting 31% from the three-point line this season. I'd like to see that number go up a little bit. That's not too bad from this team. I mean, you got shooters like Megan Parrish and Katia Luna, and those are your big three-point shooters right there.
Well, speaking of shooting, Megan Parrish leads the team in foul shots, or free throw percentage, with 65. So she shoots well from the line.
If you want to call 65% good, I mean, on this team, it's pretty good, but
yeah,
you know, 65% usually isn't.
I'm trying to look at the positives.
Fantastic, yeah. This should be a game that BCC wins. BCC needs to have, this is a must win for BCC, I think.
Well, it's pretty even with teams. It's 6-on-6 for each team with one sub.
The Rams come into this game 3-7.
That one blocked by Parrish, but gets picked up by Meadows. Meadows with the hook shot, nothing. Parrish looking to drive, goes to her right, can't get it up, but Deborah Banks with the rebound, and she puts that one in.
The boss. Banks
dominating early on.
Hey, the boss, Deborah Banks, making her shots, getting the most out of her opportunities down low now.
She's leading the team right now with points. That one through Megan's legs. Over to Staples. Surprised Staples didn't shoot that one. Looked like she had a lot of time. Meadows for three, and that one's good.
Wow. Here's that line drive three. The Rams not afraid to shoot from out there.
No, she's 2-for-3 on those today.
BCC's got to do a better job guarding the three-point line.
Edwards with the pass over. Parrish puts this one up. She shows she can shoot threes.
Megan for three. That's the same opportunity she had before, Craig, and this time she drains it. The last time she didn't make it. There's that line drive three again.
That one stuck in the corner. She gets it right back. She's going to lay it up, but that's nothing. Misha Edwards getting the rebound. Long throw over to Parrish. Nice to Banks in for two.
Wow, Deborah Great Banks movement. Becoming a scoring machine. No one's guarding her. She's wide open. Her teammates are finding her. This time, Parrish with a nice assist.
And they're just getting great movement and able to drive it into the paint for an easy two.
BCC
Speaking of driving, there's this one. Going out of bounds. Caught by Katia Luna out of bounds.
Springfield doing a poor job of getting back on defense. That's why Deborah Banks able to kind of hide in the cracks a little bit sometimes.
Yeah, definitely. This one gets inbounds. Speaking of defense, there's a three. Left her wide open, but it's no good. Staples trying to do something with it. She's going to come up with it for two.
You got to box out, and you got to be able to – you got to grab that basketball. Everybody, the girls are putting their hands up, but they're not going up to grab it. You got to get aggressive.
There's Banks. Nobody on her at all, but she can't get that one in.
Banks should have took her time there and put it off the glass. Instead, she tried to go in front of the rim.
Staples looking to drive. She's got everyone on her. She's going to make that one for and one.
I'm not sure how they count that as an and one. Looked like that was looked like there was a lot of time for that play to develop. Did they counted that basket?
No, they didn't.
Yeah, they.
No, she's not even going to go to the line. In
the NBA, they should have counted that basket, but.
No. Well, the NBA, this ain't. Staples gets it regardless, so she's going to get the stats.
Jamie Staples, another basket for her underneath. There, she's playing like she's 6'5 underneath there.
Yeah. Early on, she's got great leadership for this team. Banks from the top of the key, can't get it.
Deborah Banks becoming a go-to person.
Well, Staples brings that one down. Almost thought it was going to get stolen away.
Oh,
no
nice.
Look to Meadows. That one off
nice.
The top of the rim.
That was a nice look, though.
It was a nice no-look pass.
Yeah, nice no-look pass, but oh, nice bounce pass by Parrish.
And who else to Deborah Banks, but that one can't go in.
They're not guarding Deborah Banks. Like,
no.
She's having a layup drill over there.
Staples puts up a two. Not able to get it. This one gets kicked out by number 22, Samantha James.
Tell you, the Bayhawks have a nice little backcourt with Edwards, Luna, and Parrish on the perimeter.
Speaking of Parrish, she's going to put up a three. That one's not going anywhere. So 2 minutes remaining in the first. Bayhawks lead 14-11 coming in this game. Starting in this game. So.
Jamie Staples like a
long throw to Meadows.
I think everybody on Springfield has that line drive shot.
Looks like it. Edwards to Luna. Luna showing how to get it done.
Bang.
And she makes it. Luna
Katia
says.
Luna.
Luna says this is how you shoot a three.
Luna had a tough time, tough go of it early on in the season, but she's found that three-point stroke.
Yeah,
in the last handful of games. She really has been a go-to person out there.
Up and over, caught by Adia Contractor.
Nice pass
to Rosensteel. Rosensteel up, lays it in with the left hand.
That's it. That's the way you do it.
And she's going to go to the line.
That was textbook. I thought that was a good outlet pass by Contractor, quickly finding Mish Edwards in the open court. And then they had a nice two-on-one, and Rosensteel goes to the line to try to complete the three-point play the old-fashioned way.
Missed that one, so Rams will get it back. Jamie Staples showing off the handles.
She's a floor general.
Yep.
Wow.
That was Allie Meadows in the corner for three. 54 seconds remaining.
They swung it to Meadows in the corner. She drains the three. STC.
Rosensteel getting in the paint.
Too
Can't
hard.
Get that one. So Meadows now has this one. She's going down. Long throw over to Meadows, back to Staples. Staples is going to put up the three. This one's up for a while, but it comes down. Misa Edwards will pick it up. Edwards driving, looks
nice
to Parrish,
dish.
Puts it up. No good.
Ooh.
Parrish gets it right back. What a steal.
Good job by Parrish to get the ball right back. They give it right back to her.
There's going to be a foul on Katie Holmes for Springfield.
I like to see the ladies on the Lady Bayhawks use that glass more. They have a lot of opportunities where they're close to the basket, but they're not using the window.
Edwards puts this one up. That one's coming down. That one got rebounded by Katie Holmes, but she kind of fell down with it, almost lost it.
Oh,
nice job by Rosa
nice.
Still getting right
there
in there.
There you go. That's what I'm talking about. Come to the ball. Good job by Rosenstiel going through the lane there, and nice hand.
Staples at the buzzer. Couldn't quite get that one. That was a great job by Rosenstiel, just getting right in everyone's face and dropping the two.
Yeah. I'd like to see her be more aggressive on the offensive end. I think that will come as long as she's not in foul trouble.
Yeah, exactly. So that's been her problem as of late. Really, throughout the season, she's always been in foul trouble, at least by the third quarter.
She needs to make herself available for this team. They depend on her. I mean, they have, like I said, they have a good backcourt, good foundation in the backcourt with good shooters and Parrish and Mies Edwards and also Katia Luna. They need that front court presence. Deborah Banks has done a good job doing the dirty work, getting the offensive rebounds and kind of being the enforcer down there, being the boss. And then Shannon Rosenstiel, she needs to be all world for this team going forward. So hopefully BCC can, you know, play a complete game, something that, you know, we haven't seen. We've seen sparingly during the season. They had that win on Thursday against North Country. They just couldn't seal the deal last few minutes of the game. They kind of unraveled, and they had control in that second half, and they just kind of unraveled during the last few minutes once they lost the lead. So,
especially in the fourth quarter, they had like six fouls in a row, and then Shannon Rosenstiel got fouled out. Then I think Misa Edwards got fouled out, and I think almost one of their At least one other
yeah,
person,
they lost
I think,
a
was
couple
in foul
players.
Trouble.
Yeah, you're right. They were down to four players in the last minute. That shouldn't have happened. Now, Bristol, your phone is blowing up.
I'm a popular man.
Your phone is lighting up like the World Trade.
I'm a popular man.
Oh, my goodness gracious. I see that flash in my face. Anyway, so the last time these two teams faced at Springfield, BCC dominated. They had 102 points. It was 102-45 victory. This game was a little bit closer early. BCC needs to take care of business.
What they do as we enter the second quarter, 21-14 in favor of the Bayhawks. Nice bounce pass to Banks. Clear up and down on that one.
Banks does a good job of getting position down there and sealing off the defender. Just going to develop a couple inside moves. She's a good inside presence down there. Little lack of height, little lack of length, but still, she gets the position.
I think on that play, they realized that they need to cover her more.
It's like she turned around, didn't know what to do with it.
Yeah. Edwards to Banks. Banks up and over.
There you
and
go.
It's good. There's two.
This is going to be a Deborah Banks game. Already with 10? She got almost half the points for BCC right now.
She's been dominating so far. Staples with a deep three. No good. Rosenstiel with the rebound.
I feel those are eventually going to go in.
Nice bounce pass to Parrish. Parrish up to her left. No good.
Man.
Deborah Banks came
away.
Up with it, but she threw it away.
Edwards is such a good passer.
Staples wide open. Staples going to drive. She looked for a pass. She couldn't get it. That somehow goes in.
Dipping the shoulder in, creating the contact, and getting the foul. Jamie Staples.
She's going to go to the line to try to complete the old-fashioned three-point play. It looked like she was going for a pass, but she just had no one to pass it to, so she just said whatever and threw it up herself. I like the bench calls money, and then she misses.
Oh, nice dish by Staples to Patton for the deuce.
And Staples and Patton and Meadows, really the big three of this team we've seen so far. Rosenstiel comes away with it, puts it up off the tip. That gets rebounded by Jill Jacques.
Looked like Rosenstiel won the foul there.
Good attempt by Megan Parrish, knocking it out of bounds.
Megan Parrish always around.
She's got great court presence. Just always knowing where to be. Panton with the slow dribble. Picks up the pace.
Only 8 on the shot clock. I don't know what Springfield Technical College is waiting for. You got to shoot it. You got to shoot it. What are you doing? You got to shoot it. There is a 30-second shot clock. Good defense by BCC.
Yeah, it's taking away that shot, not allowing them to do anything.
Well, the Bayhawks are doing a good job locking up Springfield on the defensive end. They're doing a great job of making them shoot deep into the shot clock. And that's what you want to do.
Edwards on the top. That one's good for two.
Springfield is not playing defense. Mish Edwards literally walked up to the free throw line and shot it. And it's unbelievable. Wow. It's like they only want to play offense, the Rams.
That doesn't really work if you're losing. You know? Like the whole idea, if they score 100, we score 101, isn't going to work in this case right now. Especially if the Bayhawks are playing this good defense. They're letting the shot clock go down again.
Again, and forcing them into steps. You start forcing them.
We've seen that this is what this team does, is the Bayhawks, they make you make mistakes.
Yeah, like I said, they're playing good defense. And the Rams, they don't know what to do with the basketball right now.
Nope. Luna for three.
Bang!
And that one's good.
Luna!
Katia Luna for three.
That's 2 threes for her in the first half.
That's giving the Bayhawks a 10-point lead with 7 remaining in this half. Ooh, wide open is Pan, but now she's getting covered. Nice bounce pass to Meadows, up and nothing. Rosensteel, that was a slap.
Better possession there by the Rams, working it inside. That's what they need to do. They're falling in love with the 3-point shot, something they don't need to do. They're in this game. They're only down by 10. They lost the last game by almost 60 points. They're in this game on BCC's home floor.
Yeah.
Needed to just chip away.
In. Edwards, little drive, back to Parrish. Parrish thinking about it. She's going around, goes to her left, puts it up, and that one's good for two.
Going to her left. I talked about it the last game. Like to see her go more to her left. This time she does. Nice aggressive drive to her left. It puts it up with the right off the glass. Megan.
It was 6:30 remaining. Springfield's calling a timeout.
So 30-18. This is BCC's game to win. They got a comfortable lead. They're obviously their better team. You know, BCC, this is where they need to start getting their groove. We got some games coming up here. We got Roxbury next week. Next Thursday, Roxbury, the number one team in the country, comes to Bishop Conley, comes to Fall River to play BCC on their home court at 6 p.m. I believe that's going to be a doubleheader where the BCC men's team will take on Roxbury at 8 p.m. Yours truly and Craig Salvador, the Portuguese Cowboy. Portuguese Terror after 8 p.m. on a Saturday.
We got the early game today, but nice Saturday. You know, crowd's a little bit bigger today.
A little bit bigger on the Saturday games.
Yeah. It's a nice day, you know. Just come in, enjoy some basketball.
It's like 50 degrees out. Getting ready for
us is a nice day.
Yeah, getting ready for the AFC Championship game tomorrow between the Patriots and the Steelers at 6:40. I am jacked and pumped.
I'm excited as well. As Meadows goes up for two, can't get it. Rebound,
nice rebound
by Banks.
Banks becoming a force down there.
And looked like they call a foul. Either way, it's the Bayhawks ball. Edwards to Luna. Luna puts
Why
it up
not?
For three. Third foul, third three-pointer, excuse me, in a row by Katia Luna.
Why not? She's wide open. She can make it. She just drills that shot. Unbelievable.
Like you said, they're not playing defense. They're not covering her, so
no, they're
why not
playing any defense.
Meadows to Panton. 9 seconds left on the shot clock.
STC, they oh, nice.
Oh, nice move by Staples, able to get that one in for two. The shot clock winding down again.
They need more Staples. They need more of that. Staples with a nice job cut into the basket. Good job by our teammate to find her. God, what is Edward doing? Doing a little dipsy-doo over there.
A little dancing. Maybe it's for intimidation. Luna puts up another one.
Bang!
That one's good. She can't miss today. Four in a row.
Katia Luna, I told you, once she starts getting one of these modes, man, she's psycho from the three-point line.
Nice steal by Parrish. We're talking about that court presence. She's showing it off there. Driving. Pass to Edwards. Up for two.
Oh, good job by Edwards. I thought she waited too long to get it to Edwards, but a good job by Edwards to use her body to kind of get that up and out the glass. Good job by her.
I'm telling you, this team must be made of science majors because they all have great chemistry.
Oh, my God. I'm going to throw up in my mouth a little bit. Parrish, all alone. Dunk it.
I wish she dunked it. That'd be awesome.
So effortless. 40 to just like that.
Wow.
We talked about it. It was a game, 28 to 18, just a minute ago. BCC on a 12-2 run here in the last couple minutes. 40 to 20.
Luna reaching, trying to get that one back. Panton puts it up. Can't get it. Who else but Rosa Steele to get the rebound? Passing it to Parrish. Long throw over to Edwards. Edwards will put up a two. That one tips off, and that one gets rebounded by Katie Holmes.
Edwards had the shot. She was wide open.
Looks like Katie Holmes hurt herself on that.
Jamie Edwards has good handles. She should just take this. Oh, my goodness.
Very deep. No good. Well, we talked before. Jamie Staples, she's so far probably been the best all-around player, despite being one of the shorter ones. She's got great handles. She's got good speed. She can drive.
She has a great feel for the game. And she does got good handle and great court awareness.
Wow, threading the needle to Rosensteel. Puts that one up, can't get it. New shot clock, but it doesn't matter because now it's Springfield will take it.
Shannon's like one of the tallest girls on the court, if not the tallest.
There's an arc. That's nothing. Call it a pass, I guess. Katie Holmes can't do anything with it.
Lazy shot there by Katie Holmes.
Edwards going to the left. Megan Parrish goes up for it. That one's good for two.
Nice pass by Edwards. She always finds players cutting to the basket or gets, you know, she has a nice bounce pass, nice touch on those bounce passes to get it to her teammates. Yeah.
Bayhawks doing a little bit of everything so far this game. Showing great defense, great offense, great driving, great three-point shooting. They're calling a travel on Staples. Looks like Staples wanted a foul call, but she's not going to get it.
She does a good job of trying to make it look like she's – it's not a flop, but when she goes inside, it's like she's trying to – I don't know. She's a good actor when she goes in there. Like, she's getting fouled. So I guess it's almost like a flop.
It's a little
difference. She has the ball, though.
Oh, lazy pass.
Staples going to be off to the races. Oh, nice.
Again, looked like she wanted to go for a pass. Didn't have one. Tried to put it up herself, but this one's not going to go in, but she's going to go to the line regardless.
I think she's lost a little bit of confidence in her teammates because, I mean, she clearly had a bounce pass. She had a two-on-one. She decided to keep it. Couldn't connect, but she gets the foul call regardless. I'd like to see her on the Bayhawks. She'd be good. It'd be like a nice four-guard rotation with her and Megan Parrish in the backcourt.
Yeah, let's see if we can offer a trade.
A trade, college sports?
College sports.
How about a transfer?
She gets one for two with that, the foul shots. Gets swatted away, but it's going to stay for the Bayhawks.
I think Staples is just like a streaky shooter. She's not... She can get her own shot, but she's not making the shots.
Edwards goes.
Nice dish to Contractor. Nice.
Rare points, but Contractor makes it.
No one's stopping the person with the basketball. No one's stopping ball. BCC is able to just drive right in there and do anything they want.
Yeah. Long throw over, can't handle it. Bad throw right to Edwards. Parrish trips.
Oh, that's unfortunate.
But Edwards not going to be able to get it.
Yeah, that's too bad Megan fell on that one.
We saw her sit for a little bit. I think she thinks she got tripped. But there was no call.
I think she just
got fouled.
Fell. You're talking about Megan?
Yeah, I didn't really see. She was running with some people.
No, she just sometimes this court is just really slippery. You see people fall all the time. Like an ice rink.
Yeah.
You know, it makes me sad, Craig, that you're wearing that New Jersey Devils cap right now.
Yeah,
is that New Jersey Devils?
Yeah.
That's a disgrace.
Shout out to my boy, Adam Henrique. Taylor Hall, I hope you don't get injured again.
Man.
They kind of suck this year, but they're worse than the Bruins, so go Bruins. You're talking about no defense. Literally just... Edwards just walks
up
around everybody.
That's why. There you go. There you go. That's it.
Just not trying to cover them.
Rosenstiel should be going in there dominate right now. Like you said, they're not playing any defense that's worth a darn. She should be able to go right in there and do whatever she feels like doing.
Oh, big steal by Parrish.
So many steals by this lady right here.
Going to give Staples a run for her money. Can't get that one up. They're calling the foul on Staples. So with 40.3 left in the half, Parrish will go to the line.
We haven't seen a great game by Megan Parrish in this game. However, BCC still up by 23.
Yeah, effectively doubled the score of Springfield. And the problem with Springfield, we've said, they're not playing defense and they're very slow on offense. But you notice they're always, their shot clock's always winding down, and they do try to quicken the pace.
Too much on, talking about Springfield, they're focused too much on just passing the ball, but nothing's going to the rim, nothing's going to the basket.
And then when they do quicken the pace, they just throw it away.
Right. Both free throws made by Parrish.
Yep, boosting that percentage.
Yeah, a little bit. They're in a 1-2-2.
That one's stolen away by Luna. Luna almost losing it. She gives it to Parrish.
Oh,
Parrish, nice
pass.
Bounce pass to Rosenstiel.
Good job. Good job by Parrish. Just waiting just enough for the defender to kind of come creep close to her, giving her enough room to get that bounce pass into Rosenstiel. Good job. And BCC, last couple of games, have been playing this 1-2-2.
Meadows puts that one up. This will be the Bayhawks ball with 3.9 seconds left.
Springfield having a tough time figuring out this zone. BCC plays 2-3 zone from time to time, and lately been playing a 1-2-2 zone. Edwards, got
to
be aware of the clock.
Nope.
Man.
Shot's no good.
We've seen Megan Parrish train a three-pointer at the half last game. Got to be more aware of the clock. As Parrish talks to Edwards, get a chop. Good first half by BCC, halfway to 100 again.
Yeah, score 50 Bayhawks, or score Bayhawks have 50, the Rams have 23. We'll catch you back at the half.
All right, welcome back, everybody, for the second half of Bayhawks basketball, Bayhawks women basketball, as the Bristol Community College Bayhawks lead the Springfield Technical Community College Rams 50-23. Here at Bishop Conley High School, the home of the Bayhawks.
Yeah, Bayhawks had a great first half in the game, and not really starting out that way now.
Bristol Community College looking to go 6-6 in the region. They come in 6-10 overall. Springfield's 3-7, 2-4 in Region 21.
Edwards over to Parrish. Parrish down to Rosenstiel. Rosenstiel gives it to Banks. Banks with a small drive up, no good. But they will call a foul on number 21, Asia Panton. So Deborah Banks is going to go to the line.
And Deborah Banks was a force. She's going to have a double-double by the time this game is over. Already in double figures.
Well,
Deborah Rossall, she's got a nice, good stroke from the free throw line. She really get a nice shot.
I was going to bring that up. We don't really talk about it a lot, but Deborah Banks is a good free throw shooter.
She has a nice form. She bends the knees. Got a nice form. Nice shot.
Can't get that one, but Shannon Rosensteel's there. She gets the second chance, the third chance, no good.
Yeah, we
Springfield Tech finally picks it up.
We talked about those second and third chance opportunities, not being able to connect on those.
Meadows to Panton. Panton passing it back to Staples. Staples with a drive, puts it up. That one won't fall. Rosensteel came down with it, got it knocked out of her hands by Katie Holmes.
Jamie Staples for Springfield having a frustrating game. She's got good handle. She's able to get her own shot. She's able to get in the lane. She's able to create for others, but she's not making shots today.
No. Parrish gives it to Rosensteel. Rosensteel, she gets that one in for two.
Nice
shot.
Nice little turnaround hook there by Rosensteel. Nice pass by Parrish to find her.
Meadows gives it to Holmes. Holmes back to Meadows. Gives it to Panton, but this isn't going anywhere. Nice save by Banks, passing it to Luna.
A lot of tips there.
Yeah. More tips than a waiter gets. Edwards goes up for two. This one bounces back. Banks trying to save it, couldn't get it. Meadows gives it to Rosensteel. That wasn't on purpose. Luna missing her first three of the half. Staples driving. She's trying to go through everyone. That one almost went in.
She's trying to do too much.
Yep. Parrish has all the time in the world. No one on her. Easiest two in the world.
Meg with the easy lay-in. And the Bayhawks, I mean, they can just coast in this one. I'm telling you.
Well, they're already starting to run away with it.
Yeah. Save yourself.
Staples,
get ready for Roxbury next week.
As you said, Roxbury, the number one team in the state.
Number one team in the country.
In the
number
country.
One team in the
wow.
country, Craig. Don't shortchange them.
I won't.
Definitely the number one team in Region 21.
Should be exciting to see them play.
Yeah, most definitely.
Meadows, a deep three. That line drive shot is no good. It gets rebounded by Banks.
Now, Meadows there, she should have brought that in a little bit. Steps.
Yep, she knew it.
Bayhawks averages 64 points per game on the season, looking to increase that. They've had a few games where they've gone over the century mark.
Panton from two, no good. Holmes rebounds it. It's to Meadows, Staples with it. Good passing right there and gets it for two.
Good work there. Good work by Staples to find Panton.
Yeah,
that needs to be more of a dynamic duo.
Well, that one just got ripped away from Parrish.
Good defensive play by Jamie Holmes there. Katie Holmes.
Yeah. Staples for three.
Watch out for Staples as she starts to get going. Like I said, she's the engine. If that engine fires up, the Rams could creep back into this one. She seems to be the emotional leader.
Yeah, that she does. Edwards going to drive.
Thank you. Good call. Good job. Wow. Yeah. They're going to call it on. Misha Edwards seems to, she always uses that, a lot of times she uses that forearm when she's driving with the basketball to push off. This time the ref caught her, and they call her for a foul. That's her third. Got to be careful with Misha now.
Yep.
Mish.
This is a big three. No good. Panton will have it. She's going to step to the three, beyond the three-point line. Gives it over to Meadows. Meadows up. Get it. Katie Holmes just reaching over Misha Edwards to get that rebound.
Yeah, you can't give them second-chance opportunities. Springfield has, they got some height.
Yep. Staples playing very aggressive D on Parrish, who gives it to Edwards. Misha Edwards with the three.
Misha Edwards, clear as day from the top of the three-point line there. From the top of the key. Nice shot.
Staples to Penn. Meadows has it. Long throw over to Staples. Staples thought about it. Dribbling back. She's going to put that one up. Overshot it. Rosensteel comes down with it.
Nice box, though. Nice positioning by Rosensteel going up and grabbing the rebound.
Oh, Parrish wide open with that two. Contractor coming down with it. The rebound, put it up, can't do anything with it.
Good hands by Adia. She gets fouled, goes to the free throw line for two shots.
Foul be on Asia Panton, that's her third.
And I can notice the improvement from Contractor. And the last game, she had a few hoops, some big rebounds, showed good hands.
That one took forever to come down, but it goes in.
Gets the Bayhawks bounce.
Bayhawks
goes out.
I know we saw one like that last game, but it was from the other team. Remember that hit like the back of the backboard and just stood up. It went as high as the shot clock, I think.
Almost another Bayhawks bounce there. Katia Luna trying to do some dirty work. Rose's steal.
Rose's steal.
Oh. Samantha James has checked in. She came in for Panton. Number 22.
Staples looking to do something. She's going to drive instead. Put up a two. That one bouncing up. Can't get it. Contractor tips it. Meadows now right hand. Can't get it. Contractor knocks it to Rosensteel. Pass to Parrish. Parrish slowing the pace. To Luna. And it's foul on Katie Holmes. So Bayhawks are going to take this one out of bounds. And Deborah Banks checks in for Megan Parrish. Doing the pass to Edwards. Edwards puts up a three. That one just missing. But Luna has it. She's going to dribble out and step aside. Puts that one up.
Oh, nice thought, though. Good job.
Oh, Rosensteel there to pick up the
somehow.
Pieces.
Way to keep it alive. And it ends up in Rosensteel's hands, and she scores.
Well, she's the leading scorer and rebounder on this team for a reason.
Yeah, she's averaging almost nearly a double-double. She's averaging almost 15 points and 8 rebounds a game. That could be even more if she can stay in the game.
I'm yeah, sure that's right. She has always risked foul trouble, and a lot of times we see the fourth quarter with her absent.
Yeah.
Edwards gives this one to Luna. Staples trying too much. Gives that one Banks.
Ooh,
not a good
Banks
shot.
Banks had a good thought.
Contractor couldn't get it. This one's going out and everywhere.
Again, Deborah Banks with good position in there. Just turned around. She just needs to get more height on that shot. She needs to get more elevation. If she's able to work on that vertical, she can spring up and get some of these shots down low.
Meadows to Panton. Bounce pass to Meadows. That could have been a good shot there, but couldn't get it. And just a bad pass.
You know what I'm saying? Like, Banks is, she gets the ball down low, and she makes some good moves. It's just that she needs to, get up. She needs to jump. She's flat-footed. She's a little too flat-footed on some of her shots down low.
Definitely.
She could see her score. She could see herself scoring a little bit more out there.
Edwards put this one up for two. No good. Over Banks' head. Recovered by Springfield Tech. They're driving. They're going up and down. Nothing. Rosensteel got very lucky on that. Very lazy pass. Could have gone bad.
Yeah. Lucky.
Edwards is driving. A bounce pass to Banks.
There it is.
And she gets that one in. Taking it to the bank. Deborah Banks.
Yeah, and that's been a good duo right there. It's been the Edwards and Banks show. Those two working well together.
Long throw to Staples. Banks in her face. Staples can't do anything. She's going to pass it to Panton, who shoots from the free throw line. No good. Coming down easy for Edwards.
That's a better possession by Springfield, but can't make a shot. Oh, nice.
Oh, good pass to Contractor. That's the foul on Asia Panton. A lot of fouls from Springfield Tech we've been seeing.
Yep, and they have five now. Five team fouls already here in the third quarter.
And Asia Panton in foul trouble. She's got four. It's So now Contractors back to the line. So now realizing that Panton's in foul trouble, Katie Holmes will come in for her.
Holmes almost fell on that. Yep. She almost fell into the lane there, leaning over. Yep.
So Contractor goes 1-for-2 on the line from that attempt. Meadows gives it to Staples. Back to Meadows. Shot clock winding down.
Ooh, a little bit of a double team there.
Foul's going to be on Misa Edwards. So now Megan Parrish coming in. Misa Edwards now in foul trouble. She's got 4.
Yep, and still a lot of game left.
Yeah, we're only in the third period, the third quarter at this point.
Man.
Deep three by Staples, no good.
Man.
Into the hands of
Rosen Steele.
You don't
need to take that shot from way out there. Bring it in a little bit.
Bounce pass, Rosen Steele goes
good
up for
job.
2.
And that's a nice bounce pass from Parrish. Nice hands by Rosen Steele. Goes baseline and puts it through the twine.
Springfield calling a timeout. 2:12 remaining in the third. 66-30 in favor of the Bayhawks.
The C team. Cardoza, Craig, the Cowboy, and Cabral. The Portuguese connection.
In the most Portuguese city, Fall River.
Ladies and gentlemen, on Friday, you can listen to the Lucy. You can listen to the I Love Lucy show on bccradio.org. That's at 10 a.m. on Fridays. Also, listen to the Dirty Water Sports Hour. That's at 4 p.m. on BCC Radio as well. We're talking all things Boston sports and more. That's the Dirty Water Sports Hour with Cardoza and Andrews.
And I know
this week, hopefully, we'll be talking about a Patriots victory in the AFC Championship game.
And I no longer have classes at those times, so you might be able to catch me on those shows at some point.
Yeah. Love to get the Cowboy on there.
Inbound it now, Meadows and Staples. Salvador. Meadows and Staples have been kind of the big two of this team. Them and Panton been seeing the main contributors, but it's really just been Staples this game and definitely seen her be visually frustrated.
Well, Staples, I like the energy that she brings. Number 3, Jamie Staples, I like the energy that she brings to the team. She seems to be a floor general out there. She's got good handle.
Now Shannon Rosensteel's in familiar territory. She's now in foul trouble.
But Staples for the Rams, doesn't seem like she has a lot to work with. I mean, you got Asia Panton not playing her best game today, and they're shooting too many hero shots. They're shooting like NBA range, like Steph Curry shots. They don't need to be doing that right now. What are you doing?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, Jamie Luna for 3. That one not able to go in. Pass back. Staples coming down. Stops, puts it up
there
for 2.
There you go. That's a good shot right there. Stopping and popping at the elbow. Gets it to fall.
Megan Parrish gives it to Banks. Banks going in the paint. Gets her own rebound. Puts that one up for 2.
Oh,
no
nice
good.
Effort,
this one
though.
Coming back. Staples has it. Parrish trying to get on her. She's going to throw
Ooh.
That one up. No good.
Good job using her body.
That one went out of bounds. A little miscue by Deborah Banks and Shannon Rosensteel.
Good to see Shannon on the floor today. That's her 4th, though. And they have 2 players with 4.
Staples putting that one
there
up for 2.
There it is, back-to-back baskets.
Great mid-range shot right there. Parrish dribbling over to Luna.
Ooh.
Ooh, too much. She's going up for 2. No good. Banks has it. She's trying to take a step back. They're calling a big travel on
They're going to call travel. I don't know. I think there was some contact there. They're going to call steps, though. Yeah. And one of the Rams players had their hand in the basketball. I don't know. Looked like it might have been a jump at least.
Yeah, at least. 30 seconds left in the third quarter.
I was thinking, what's going to happen? You know, they have obviously BCC has a big cushion, but they have two key players in Misha Edwards and Shannon Rosendiel that both have four fouls. What if both of those players go out? Can they hold on? They should be able to hold on, right, for one more quarter with a 30-point lead, 32-point lead?
At least. And we've seen, like we said, Springfield Tech,
they're not
playing defense. So, and Deborah Banks, Megan Parrish still having good games. So
yeah, they could give them like a 5-3 power play for the final quarter and be able to seal this deal.
Yeah, exactly.
Still, I was thinking about Katia Luna Craig. A lot of times she gets the basketball, it seems like she's not facing the basket, like she's not square with the basket. It's like she's shooting it from the side. It's like a weird release. A lot of times she makes it, but I feel like sometimes she's really not squared with the basket, and it's just I think it caused her shot to be a little way off base, way off the mark.
Yeah, it's like she's throwing from her hip, kind of like that's her starting point.
Yeah, it's like I don't know, it's a weird thing, but it goes in.
So Allie Meadows is at the line, she misses her first shot. Misses her second one. Deborah Banks gets a rebound.
Deborah Banks clearly with a double-double here today. She's been outstanding.
And Parrish looking at the clock. She got 20 seconds. Remember last game she put one up
nice
at the buzzer.
Pick.
Nice pass to Luna.
That's
that one's
nice.
Good for
beautiful,
two.
Beautifully done. Deborah Banks sets the edge, sets the pick. Megan Parrish goes around and drops it over there.
Yep. 3 seconds left. She's got to do something.
To Banks.
Throws this one up.
Up.
Oh.
68-34.
Yep. Bayhawks effectively doubled the score of Springfield. So that wasn't, even though it was an exciting shot at the buzzer, not much to hold your breath about.
Exactly. Still would have been impressive, though.
Oh, it would have been very impressive, especially since she had two people on her.
Yeah,
like, all up in
her
face. That one had a chance. It bounced around a little bit.
As we said, BCC going to be playing the number one team in the country, Craig. Roxbury, number one team in Region 21, playing them 6 p.m. here. And also coming up to round out the month at Holyoke and at the Naval Prep. At the Naval Prep School on January 31st. Those are the upcoming games. And pretty soon, Craig, we'll be getting to that point in the season where it's going to be crunch time. As we get into tournament season in February.
Talking a little playoff basketball.
Playoff basketball, yeah. We got the state tourney, which is the MACAC. Hope I'm saying it right.
Close enough. They know what you're talking
Close
about.
Enough. Yeah, you know what I'm talking about. And then also the Region 21 tournament. Those two tournaments are back-to-back. So those are all things to come. And as we talk about the Bayhawks, they didn't have a team last year. So for them to possibly get their seventh victory and be 500 in Region 21, this is a huge deal.
Well, it just shows how far they've come along. These are, like we've said before, these are people from all different places all coming together. They're having great chemistry and all that in a season. Like we said, they're all freshmen. So next year, we're going to have a very, very good team next year.
Yep, and then having whatever recruits they, you know, come in. Could have a deep team because this is a good core. That is, they've been this team started up with about 9 or 10 players. They had a deeper team. This is the core that stayed together and wants to play, wants to be out there.
So we're beginning in the fourth quarter. Shannon Rosen still on the bench, avoiding foul trouble right now.
Well, they don't need her right now either, Craig. I mean, 68-34. Why risk anything? Why risk an injury? Why risk her going out? They get a big game on Thursday, so that I'm sure they wouldn't have a good showing in. Why not? Just rest her.
Exactly. some confusion on the court.
But it seems to be a good group. They're playing better. They're more, you talked about chemistry. They got more chemistry now than they did at the beginning.
That they do. Pass over to Staples. Staples bouncing off of Banks, throws that one up, gets tipped away. Misa Edwards coming with it. Still coming with it. Now she has it. Going down, she is surrounded, so she slows her pace a little. Over to Parrish. Thought about it, decides to drive. Goes up for two.
Nice aggressive drive by Parrish. Getting into the lane, can't connect on that one, but nice drive. BCC doing a good job with that zone.
Yeah, call it a carry on Staples, Jamie Staples.
Well, Springfield is 3-7 for a reason. Hands up. Staring at eight. Oh.
Ooh. Luna starting to go cold with those three-pointers.
Yeah, I think we jinxed her. We were talking about how she was going off in the first half. She had like three, she had four threes in the first half. Gone cold here in the second half.
Oh. Ooh. Lazy pass. Well, if anything's been proven over the last few weeks, I'm the king of jinxing things.
I'm the king of jinxing.
I called Aaron Rodgers' throw that won them the game. I said before the game.
Please predict a Steelers victory then.
Okay.
Steelers. Go say go Steelers.
No, no. Yeah, fair enough. I mean, I did say Aaron Rodgers was going to win it with like 3 seconds left, so I was kind of right. We called it a double dribble.
Deborah Banks, not a guard. Wouldn't mind seeing Patriots-Falcons.
As long as the Patriots win.
I like Matty Ice. Yeah.
Deep three, that line drive shot we've talked about.
Matty Ice is a humble guy. You know, he's had a great season. Underrated quarterback, and he went to BC.
I always call the Falcons the best team that no one cares about.
No. I don't think anybody wants to see the Falcons.
I didn't even realize they were in the playoffs until the playoffs started. I don't think anyone really.
I know.
Never right? Really hear them talk about the Falcons.
And they were a second best team in the NFC this year. Mm. They had a bye. Matt Ryan is MVP candidate. Not better than Brady, but anyways, 70-34 now, huh?
Staples looking for something.
Everybody's looking for something. the things we talk about when it's 70-34.
Yeah, we have fun at these blowouts. Meadows with a long drive into no man's land, and a fan gets a souvenir.
That would have went over my head.
That means it would have went over my head, too. You were much taller than me.
It would have went over my head with you on my shoulders. Trust me. All right, Megan Parrish being nonchalant, walking this ball up over the timeline.
Got 8 minutes left in this game. We'll cross up over to Banks. No good. Gets tipped up.
Is that Holmes?
Nice pass over to Staples.
Oh, nice.
Staples crossing up.
She faked Megan Parrish out of her shoes. So. Good job by Issa. A little stutter step, little delay, and Megan was flying at her. She just flew past her. Good job by Miss Jamie Staples.
Then we're just showing how the defense isn't there as Edwards puts that one up for ease.
Telling you, I'm liking that Jamie Staples. If she was on the Bayhawks, you know, Megan might have some competition as far as who's my favorite player. Mm. Look at that!
Wow.
She's a one lady wrecking crew. One woman wrecking crew.
Well, Springfield now, they're showing if you're going to shop anywhere, you shop at Staples.
Nice drive.
Now Megan Parrish, not to be outdone, gets that one for two.
Nice drive by Megan Parrish getting into the lane, laying it out the glass. Megan goes hard at the rim. That's
it's
a good matchup.
Hard. Wow.
And again, Jamie Staples breaking Megan Parrish's ankle. Sorry, Megan.
Yeah.
Those two battling back. I think there's a little rivalry here. We got to develop something here, Craig.
I should talk to Jamie Staples after the game, tell her all the benefits of coming to BCC, get her to transfer.
I want to see Parrish and can we get a wrestling match? Oh, look at that.
Wow.
Where was this earlier? This is a Jamie Staples show right now.
I think she realizes that she's been the only contributor to her team.
Well, she should have did this earlier. She tried to earlier, but the shots just weren't going down. Oh, nice dish.
Wow.
Oh, Adia, too hard. It's Staples versus Parrish at WrestleMania, Hell in the Cell. WrestleMania 33.
I don't have anything to say to that. It's moments like this. I wonder what they say when they're reviewing the tapes.
Oh, they are. They hear it. Trust me.
Yeah,
oh,
I know.
You said this. Oh man.
Shannon Rosensteel back into the game.
Last year during the tournament games, they told me I was being too critical. You're being too critical of the team.
Bounces around that one. It's a fall.
All right, Staples.
Hey, at this pace,
Staples has scored like 10 points in the last few minutes.
They got 6 minutes left. Staples gets, 10, like every 30 seconds they can win it.
Parrish all trying to do Staples right now. It's like, that girl got more points than I do.
They're up by 30 at this point.
One thing about BCC, they've all been pitching in these last couple games. They really all been contributing. It hasn't been just one player.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, everyone doing their part. We saw Katia Luna. She had a big hand in the first half. Deborah Banks getting
Ooh. Holy smokes, what a collision. Easy, Adia. You're gonna kill that girl.
That's number 22, Samantha James. Hope she's okay.
Yeah, Samantha James, a little bit on the frail side. She got that was an absolute collision.
Yeah.
Hopefully that's what we see tomorrow. It's like a Dante Hightower shot right there.
Yeah. Deep, big three, nothing. Contractor.
80 is getting upset.
They're going to call that it's the
I love the aggressiveness.
Rams ball. It was a deep pass.
She got a good arm.
Meadows with a spin move. Going to throw that one up. Gets nothing. Tipped out of bounds. Going to stay down. But yeah, like we were saying, pretty much everyone on the team been contributing some way, shape, or form, Megan Parrish is Megan Parrish, so she's always going to have a good game. Rosensteel, again. Misa Edwards, again. Deborah Banks really putting on a show. Katia Luna, we talked about the first half, really.
Very balanced, you're right. As the Rams score again. But, yeah, Luna had, three or four? She had four threes.
I think she had, four in a row.
And they drop it into Rosensteel. Shannon's got her points. Megan Parrish has been distributed and driving the lane, scoring points. And, Misha Edwards knocking down some jumpers. And Deborah Banks had a big first half. And
ooh, no hands.
Deborah Banks had a double-double. She had 10 points within the first, 10 minutes of this game, so it's been a good balanced attack, and it's been a good bounce back victory.
We'd always seen her as an offensive rebounder, and now that she's getting the points, it's really showing just how far she's coming. Kicked away, no man's land, no woman's land, I should say.
There it is.
Luna with the three, you jinxed her.
Banks all over the board. She's all over the boards today. Good job by Shannon Rosensteel.
That's a good thing to have. They like to shoot threes, even if they're going to miss them. They're going to have someone down there. Line drive three. Even if the Bayhawks miss a three, they got someone always down there to pick it up.
Yeah.
From the most line drive three to the loftiest two we've ever seen.
Patton, she spent her time a lot more on the perimeter when I think she should be downside. She's kind of lean, though, so.
Edwards with no one on her, all the time in the world for that three.
Ooh. Adia's going to keep that ball up there. She Oftentimes, she gets that rebound up high. She's got to keep it up high so no one else can get it. She brings it down too much, I think, and is hesitant.
Nice bounce pass. Panting up. Nothing. Edwards has it. I was going to bring that up with Contractor. She had it and just brought it down immediately and pretty much lost it. Bad pass.
Too late on the dish there.
Yeah. Staples. Look, nice beyond the back.
She got game.
Now we've seen her. She has shown her handles this game. Going behind the back, through the legs, doing it all.
Hey, Jamie, come to BCC next year.
Good pass game, Panton. Over to Holmes. Stolen by Parrish.
Okay, who's Gardner? Oh. Come on. They don't like each other.
Since it may be like a LeBron Steph kind of rivalry, there's
no
the respect
pat in the
there.
Back. Like, Staples just hacked her, you know. Megan missed. Like, there was no, like, hey, you know, good job, you know.
Well, Staples gave her a pat on the shoulder.
Oh, did she?
Yeah. She was like, hey, nice.
I don't think Parrish cares.
She's cold-blooded.
Well, don't they say all women secretly hate each other?
Something like that.
I've heard that before.
Lucy, is this true? she gives us the thumbs up.
You know, women always do that. Oh, they're going to be calling me a sexist on this telecast. I need to stop.
Yeah, you're getting the blame for this. I'm not taking part
of it. I'm always toeing the line, you know.
If we're in it, yeah. Always the center of controversy, am I right?
More C's.
More C's
center
controversy.
Of controversy when you talk about Cardoza, Cabral, and Cowboy Craig.
The killer C's.
The killer C's.
Killer spelled with a C, obviously.
Yeah. Killer spell.
Lofty pass over to Staples.
Look at this. Just telling you, this is the rivalry.
She's looking to drive. She's going through everybody. Can't get that one in. That's something that we've been seeing a lot from her, those drives.
Oh, she's very imaginative with the basketball. Oh,
Pass Banks. Over to Banks.
There
That's
it,
it
is.
For two.
And you know, Craig, last game you got to call the player of the game, so I think I'll call that today. When this game is over.
Yep. That one got ripped out of Staples' hands, but they're gonna call white ball.
Gonna check to see how many points Deborah Banks has. I'll be right back, because we don't have the luxury of having a statistician come up here and be like, "Hey, some stats, guys."
So, Issa Edwards now dribbling. Dave very hesitant. He's thinking about a big call. Oh, he's going down. I am left alone. It's just like prom all over again. My friends back home will appreciate that joke. So this one gets dribbled down by Jamie Staples. Up over to Meadows, back to Staples. Looked like she was going to pass. He takes it herself. Line drive three. That one's good. Allie Meadows for three. I don't think we've seen her make a three since the first quarter of this game. And it's 78-51, 125 remaining. There was the Parrish. Parrish driving, going up and over to her left. That one's no good. She's not getting a call. So now Panton will be dribbling. Pass over to Staples.
Parrish, I think Megan
Parrish trying to steal it. Goes out of bounds.
I think Megan got hit in the face there.
Maybe. So what'd you find out, Dave?
Well, Deborah Banks has 15. This is her largest output of the season. Mm. But obviously, I mean, she's been a force on the boards. But I mean,
lofty pass over to Meadows. Allie Meadows stepping back, pass over to Penn, who's at the free point line.
Oh,
stolen by Rosen
Rose
Steele.
Steele.
Rosen Steele, as she is starting to drive up, can't get it. Gets her own rebound, misses again.
You
wow.
gotta be kidding
this
me!
This is like
you got to be kidding me!
That's like
Shannon.
YMCA basketball right there.
Three opportunities at it. Staying flat-footed.
Rosenstiel on the field, on the court, saying, "I can't jump."
That seems to be the case.
It doesn't look like it's going to matter.
A lot of players on the team.
We got less than 30 seconds left in the game.
I think
with a sizable lead.
Megan Parrish is the only one that can get off the ground.
That was a hard pass, big steal. Not really going to matter at this point. You know.
Winding down this one.
Yep.
Good victory. Big victory for BCC to come up at 500 in Region 21. Yep. That's a good victory by them.
Time to tuck it in. Kiss your kids goodnight. Kiss your kids goodnight. It's time to put this one to bed.
All right. BCC sweeps the season series with Springfield. They may face each other again when it comes down to tournament time, but my player of the game is going to be none other than Deborah Banks. Had to give it to her, the boss Deborah Banks. I thought in the first half she really asserted herself, and, I mean, she was scoring left and right, and another double-double by her. She was very good on the boards. And in the first half, this game was over, and Deborah Banks was a big part of that. Some other great contributors for BCC as always, but I'm going with the boss Deborah Banks as our Bayhawks player of the game. Yep.
So with the final being 78-51 with the Bayhawks win, stay tuned as we'll be back for the men's game coming up, and we'll catch you later.